you are doing in all of our lives, Lord. I thank you, Father, that you grace us with your presence, Lord. And I thank you, Father, that you open your word up, Father. You help us see, Lord. But before we see, we believe. So, Father, I thank you that Andrew believes in you and he trusts you. He has faith in you, Father. And we thank you for the word that you've given him for us today. That fresh manna, Lord, always that will encourage us and help us to fly for you, Lord, in Jesus' name. Holy Spirit, come. Holy Spirit, let it be as you lead, in Jesus' name. Amen.
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 Oh, we're back to this. Morning.
Morning.
So, I am thinking of Motley Crue, yeah. But I'm actually thinking God's army, not Dad's army, but God's army today. Just so go to someone near you and just say to them, "You are part of God's army." You managed to stretch that out a bit, didn't you? And you know, the word that we heard today was believe and you'll see. Like on the other day, I mean, someone said, "Do I believe that would be Vivian's bag?" Absolutely not. But sometimes we just need to see it, don't we? But God says the opposite. He says, believe, and then you'll see. Let's stand. Get ready for some action today. Because God's on the move today. Do anybody think they're going to leave here the same as... Who wants to leave here the same as when you walked in?
No.
Who wants just about a nice little Sunday where we can go home and say, that was nice. Let's go to a nice dinner. Let's go back home to our nice place and have a nice rest of the Sunday. That'd be good, wouldn't it? That'd be nice. Yeah.
Nice.
No.
Or do you want what God's got for you?
Amen.
Because today he wants to show you and speak to you a word. He's given me the word and I said, that'd be great, Lord. I've got some great things to say about that. He says, have you? Well done, Andrew. Now I'm going to tell you what you're going to say. So you're going to see and hear what we sing and pray about, which is God's miracles, which is God's healings, which is God's movement, which is God's ways, and it's God's all because of God's love. If you want that, you're in the right place.
Amen.
But just as we've been heard so many times over and over again, that when Moses was surrounded, wasn't he, by armies, and he couldn't go either way, and the water was there and he was trapped, the waters didn't move first. What moved first? Moses' feet. I believe. And then the miracles came. So you ready to do this with me?
Yeah.
So I believe you, God. And then the waters open. If you're ready for that today, then you do that physically, mentally, spiritually, whichever way you want to do, But you have to take a step of faith first and say, Lord, I believe that you are a miracle worker, and I stand in the goodness of that. And then watch those waters move. Are you ready for that?
Yes.
We're all okay. Gilly's awake. We're all ready. Okay, let us thank Jesus. Thank you, Lord. You just thank him wherever you are for whatever you think you need to thank him for. Because he's done something in your life this week that is miraculous, that is signs and wonders, because actually signs and wonders follow us, do they not?
Yeah.
Are they meant to? Is it just for Debbie?
No.
Is it just for Howard?
No.
Is it just for Leonard?
No.
It's for all of God's people. He said, signs and wonders follow you.
Amen.
I'm up for that.
Amen.
Who's hiding behind the pillar? I'm up for that. And Linda is too. So let us thank you, Jesus, that you've given us eternal life. Thank you, Jesus, that our names, you said yes to you, are written in the book of life. And thank you, Lord, that we don't want to just sing them. We don't just want to read them, but we want to experience your ways and your wonders. So we stand in faith today and watch as we say, yes, I believe, and then I will see the wonders of you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Yeah, you can sit down. Oh, hang on. Now we go. So one thing I did get revelation, and what I'm going to speak today is actually about last week. Oh. Because lots of questions were asked about last week. So I thought, yeah, that was good. Let's move on. It's Monday now. But God said he wants to remind you and speak to you and show you about what happened last week. Because unless our spiritual eyes are open, we miss those signs and wonders which God wants you to experience just because he wants to. No, because he loves you and he wants you to grow. And he doesn't want you to remain babies. And in this time, in this era, in this place of history which we're in, he's really moving, isn't he?
Yes.
Is he really moving? He's really moving. And I believe we're going to see even more signs and wonders. But not just in a select few, but in all of you. And the word that we heard from Howard today is that God is speaking to you today. To the people of the earth. To people in this room. Who's in this room? So who's he speaking to then? Whatever reason that you may be here, he's speaking to you personally today so that you will see him. And you will go, wow, I want a bit more of you, Lord. Less of me and more of you. Do you know, I learned today that I've often wondered, and I thought I had the answer, but I often wondered why God healed me of the cancer through doctors first, but of the leukemia, he did it directly, even before they touched me, which he never did in the end. I was healed, as those you know, healed of leukemia before the doctors got hold of me. That's God. But I often wondered, why did he do it that way around? And he gave you a revelation this week after Sunday. And he said, and he reminded me of the leper. Do you know the lepers?
Sure.
Now the lepers, that leprosy affected the whole of their life. Every part of it. Spirit, soul, body. It affected them. In every way. And it was also affecting their blood.
Yeah.
And in their blood, Leviticus 17:11, one of my favorite verses, always has been, the life of the creature is in the
blood.
So the two big signs that was prophetic that the Messiah would do when he came was, one, he would talk in parables, and the second one, he would heal lepers. Because there was no such thing as healing leprosy. No one did it. So since two of the signs of the coming of the Messiah, of which Jesus did, was that he would talk in parables, didn't he? And did he not heal one leper after another? In fact, he made a point of it. He would go around saying, oh, here's a leper. He would point them out, pick them out, and Jesus would make a point of it. Why? Because he liked lepers. Because he wanted to show you that who he was. Miracles are about him showing you not just how wondrous he is, but showing you him. Showing you that he is who he is. As Carol's also said, the I am. And with this leprosy, for them to be healed of a thing that was would affect their blood and their whole life, they would need to be touched by the only blood, the blood of the Lamb, which is Jesus, for them to be healed for the whole of their life. Isn't that beautiful? And this is when I fell out of bed. Is when I realized then that he let the doctors heal me first of the cancer with them first, but him directly with the leukemia, because leukemia is a blood order. And therefore, for me to be completely healed of the whole of the blood order, the blood of the Lamb had to come into my life and wash me clean of all disease. And a few tests ago, probably this some whatever many months ago it was now, is that it fell upon the report, which it was all in Spanish. So I didn't have Jody with me, or can you speak just in Spanish? But some noticed it and read it out. And it said, did you know here that it reads, you have absolutely no sign of the disease in your blood? Because the blood of Jesus washes us clean. When he says yes, and his promises, we've sung it, but do we really know it in our heart? When he says it, he means it. Isn't it beautiful? That's got absolutely nothing to do with what I want to say, but I'll just give you that one for free. But actually, it is linked, because what happened last Sunday? What happened last Sunday? So I want you to see what physically happened, and then I want you to see what God wants to show you. 2 weeks before that, I was quite sick in the toilet. But remember what God's promises to us. God's promise was 7 years ago, not only I would be healed, but I would be always that way. So therefore, whatever I see, I know is okay. And if you remember when the times when we didn't know what the diagnosis was, God kept on saying to me, even though you're bleeding, even though you're sick, even though you're in pain, all will be okay. And when I proclaimed the beautiful name of Jesus, everything left. But 2 weeks ago, I was sick in the toilet and blood came out. That ain't a good sign, is it? Only a little bit. But last Sunday, on the way here, and I want you to see the timings of things. Just listen to all these words that you're going to hear carefully, because you will be enriched. Your faith will grow. You shall not leave here the same as when you come in. You've asked for it. The Lord's going to give it to you. Now you stand in faith and receive it. Is that an amen?
Amen.
Let's get on with it. So then that morning at 10 to 11, I was downstairs and I was sick again. But a lot more. But nothing, I hadn't eaten anything. There was nothing that could have been eaten. So my eyes were closed, knowing that there was nothing there, but I just need to be sick. But when I opened my eyes, the toilet was full of blood, but a lot more. And as I looked up like that, I just saw something right at the bottom of it. This is quite relevant. I'm not giving you all the gory details, but it is relevant. As I looked into this toilet, there's nothing in there except blood. It's alright, nothing. No one else. And in there was like, looked like a cork, you know, like an apple cork. It looked like that. I thought, what's that? So actually, my eyes are dazed a bit. I picked it up, put it in a tissue, and kept it. Sorry for the glory there. I know. Now what's happening? It's tomorrow. It's your blessing tomorrow. I won't talk to her because she starts praying. We love you, we do. Anyway, so moving on swiftly. So I picked this out and put it in the tissue. Now this tissue was covered now in this and in the blood. So I put it in there. I came out of the toilet quite dazed. And the first two people I see were Kimberly and Vivian. I've never seen two people's faces go white so quickly. Bless them. big smiles, and then it was amazing. But they came up here, and then two other people came along. Alexandra and Henry. And they went a little bit whitish. Normally with Alexandra you get two things, big smiles, or this. It went from like this to this very quickly. And I said, no, everything will be okay. You go up and start without me. I knew everything was going to be okay, I just didn't know how. But they came back down, bless them, and said, we can't leave you, we'll just pray for you. And they did it. That was the start of what God wanted to show, that we are all in part of God's army in this together. So, what I want you to see is the video that was sent of this place. And if we have that video, we're going to put it on now. Chapter 12, verse 5, and I love the book of Acts. It says, so Peter was kept in prison, but the church was earnestly praying to God for him.
Peter was kept in prison, but the church
was earnestly praying for him. That's a picture of Acts. The church, and God showed us a few things in that video, and that's that you were all not only together, but you're all linked with arms. And you'd all formed a circle nearly around the front. And if you did, and if you look closely, and if you ask God, you will see two other things there: angels and fire. Did you see? Have another look next time if you've got the video. Angels and fire were there too. But that was going on while we were on the way to the Cost of El Sol. But I want us to see that what happened in Acts chapter 12 was that Peter was also in trouble. He was in prison, but it says, it doesn't say and, it says, but the church were praying. Peter's in prison, but the church was praying. Yeah. Can we say it again? Peter was in prison, but the church was praying. Yeah. Alexander. He was in prison, but the church was praying. Can you see? But God's in it. And the power that we have, he wanted to show you what he can do when we're together and when we put our foot forward and say, I trust in you, God. Isn't it beautiful? What you didn't know was that then in the car, then he chose a song. And she chose a song and said, I've got to put this song on. And the song was, God's God of with angel armies. And halfway through that song, breakthrough.
Hallelujah.
Breakthrough.
Hallelujah.
Breakthrough. Whatever you need in your life right now, breakthrough is on its way. When you step. Did you all do it? Did you not do it? Stand up and do it again. No one's worried. If you didn't do it, do it again. You're making a stand for God that you're going to trust in his promises, in his faithfulness, in his righteous ways, and that the waters will open, but you've got to put your foot out first. And then watch out. Whatever situation that you're in, the promises of God, whatever he's got for you, you stand in faith first, and then you thank him for what he's about to do. So through that, breakthrough came. But did you notice in that Acts chapter 12, angels took hold of Peter. In fact, they got hold of Peter, who was sitting there with a little bit of faith, and the angel knocks him. Wake up! Wake up, he says. Are you awake? Wake up and watch what God's about to do. Wake up! And chains fell off. Spiritually, this is real. Wake up! God of angel armies are here. Look what God's about to do and follow me.
Hallelujah!
Amen! That's the word I wanted to hear. Was that?
Hallelujah!
Let's get a Mexican wave going. It's got a Miroslav wave that high, by the way. So the God's armies, once he said, wake up the things that we're about to do, and they walked out free from that prison. Isn't it beautiful? This is you now. You're maybe imprisoned in something. And God's of angels' armies are shouting, wake up! For the things are about to change.
Amen.
You're about to be set free even more. You're going to be released into the things he's called to be released into. And he's going to say, because it's all in me. And then we got to the hospital, and I want you to notice the timings of here, because if you remember, in Acts chapter 12, Peter came out of the prison, angels had released the chains, and Peter went back to the place where the people were praying. And they were so excited, this girl called
Rhoda.
This girl called Rhoda, she answers the door, says, hello, Peter, and she's that excited, she slams the door back on his face and runs and tells everybody. Peter's back. A miracle's just happened. We've just been praying, and a miracle's just happened. I hope you're seeing the relevance of this. We're in the hospital, and we've gone to Costa del Sol, and back. We've even took a detour back home because I forgot someone's car key. Brought it then back to the church, and we were still here where the people were praying. Are you not seeing this is the book of Acts? I believe that if we're able to believe and then we will see, we're going to see more and more of this outpouring of his love and of his blessings and of his faithfulness and of his righteousness and of his signs and of his wonders and of his angels and of his fire. All we're going to do is shout, fire, Lord! Bring that fire down upon us if you really mean it. Fire does two things as we heard this week. It does, it burns. It kills off. And it purifies. And God, if you want to really shout for the fire today, then he wants to kill off the things in you which may hold you back. Any doubts, any things, he may burn them off. If you shout, no one's going to force you, but at the end, you're going to shout, I'm going to have the opportunity for you to shout fire to come down. And if you really mean it, God's going to act, but it's going to be burning away things that you may not want to get rid of, but he's going to burn them for your sake because he loves you, so that you can be more purified, more made beautiful. So when he returns, he sees the great work he's done and says, there's my bride. She prepared herself for me. The bridegroom's returned and he's going to come back for his beautiful one. So when we're in the hospital, get back to that point. Don't forget, this is the Costa del Sol on a Sunday. Anyone been there on a Sunday? I'm booked in. I must have been booked in advance. Because when I got there, my name came up. I mean, sat down. And then when that happened, I sit down, my name comes up again. You try that. The two ladies that were with me, Debs and Bernsey, the two nurses, they Bertie says she actually never seen anything like it. But that was just only one little miracle. So when I got called in straight away, he said, sit down, please. I said, no, that's okay. I wasn't going to be staying there long. That's what I'd like you to know. What I really meant was, I don't want to be here. But I pulled out the tissue and here's the next miracle. That tissue, that core thing, had completely disappeared. In the logical trying to come in, the flesh trying to come in, and it was, wasn't there. Maybe that was just something that was mere imagination. No, I picked it up out of the toilet, and it was covered in blood, and it was real, like an apple core. That had disappeared, and no one knew this, but I kept on folding through the tissue looking to see what was there. It vanished. Not only that, there was only spacket split. Is that a word? What's that word? Spacket. A spacket bit of blood. He's being generous. No such word, he says. A little bit of blood left on a tissue that was covered. It disappeared. So she said, and the first words, she didn't even look at anything, says, that's not blood. It's certainly not your blood, she said. She looked on the screen and there's witnesses. Honestly, what? Yeah. Oh, you weren't there. You were, where were you? You passed out. Bertie was there. And she said, and it's certainly not your blood. She then went on the computer and says, oh look, and it confirms it. You've got nothing in your blood. You are a very healthy young man. I said, I like it. I was out in 2 minutes. And you think, why that? She actually said, do you want to do some tests? No. Why would that happen so fast? I mean, we were talking about it in the car. We were quite, wow. What happened with Rhoda? What happened with Rhoda, Rod? They came back, and as we came back in the car, we realized that God had done at least one miracle. But throughout the week, we realized he'd done more than that. And that's what I wanted him to share with you today, even more than that. Do you know, we arrived back through the doors at 12:30, just before. And bless him, Elvis turns around. Fonzie says, look who's here. But Elvis, just before that,
don't anybody look.
Yeah. And as Elvis noticed beforehand, and he turned around and gave me the most amazing welcome. They left me hanging then. Just like Rhoda. Shut the door, raised and walked off. Near enough, exactly that. And then I patted him on the head and we had a hug. But Elvis greeted. And then what we saw after that was an outpouring because of God's love. Do you remember what happened? It's a pity that's not on video. All we got on video is Fonzie's face like that. And bless him, he then had to carry on with his preach. But God knew what he was doing. So what I think that he wants to show us today is that we can have our trust in him. And it's not what we see with our eyes. It's not what we feel. It's not what we think we're looking at. It's not how much whatever pain we're in. It's spiritual. It's far greater than the physical. And the truth is spiritual is greater than everything. And God, who is love, is greater than all things. Whatever Satan wants for evil, God will turn it around for good.
Amen.
Look at the good in that. As one, you are bonded together for a purpose of which God used and says, that's beautiful. I can use these people and I can show them my power. They're ready for the next bit. Do you know, there's a guy called, he's not alive now, Benson Idahoser. Anyone heard of him? He was a Nigerian apostle, stroke evangelist, stroke something else. And he had quite a ministry. But before that, he was a witch doctor. I've stayed quite a while with a witch doctor. I think I may have said it before, and I saw and heard the most incredible things. Things that you wouldn't even believe. In fact, he told me things that he said to me, you're not going to believe this. Where things were changed in front of her very eyes. I believe that God changed wine into water into wine. Do we believe that?
Yes.
Do we believe, therefore, that he can change anything into anything?
Yeah.
Therefore, I believe he turns my blood that was on that tissue into water, and it disappeared off. Is that too far-fetched then? Absolutely not. Where did he go then? And it wasn't even my blood? It wasn't even blood? Because God's a God of miracles. But this geezer, Benson Idahoser, he was a witch doctor, and he said that there's two things that can't be demonized, he called it. Demons can't touch. And those were doves. That's interesting, isn't it? All 19 times in the Bible where a dove is mentioned is the Holy Spirit. But the physical dove, they could demonize any animal, and they did do. And they can demonize humans, but they couldn't touch the dove. But there was a second type of person that they couldn't demonize. And let me tell you, they can see spiritual stuff far more than most Christians. Far more. He said the second thing they can't touch is praying Christians. Because guess what? What do we see in that video? Because there's a circle of fire around them. I hope you're getting this. Because this is going to last you forever. It's going to last me forever, and it's going to help you. A circle of fire was around you last Sunday. God's armies were set on their path to put around me because of your prayers on last Sunday. Fire was given around you so that those Holy Spirit-led fiery prayers went up to heaven. And blessings came pouring down. Surrounded by fire when you pray. Can't be touched. Is that beautiful?
Yeah.
In the Bible, it talks of living stones. In fact, we heard someone say that today. Living stones, of which Jesus is the cornerstone, the living stone. And we're living stones. And that word in there we've heard is the word Aben in Hebrew, which means sons and daughters of God. So we are stones. But it there says we are living stones. And that word is connected with another word, which is precious stones. And precious stones is how we build our Christian walk with one another. We build one another up, and as we do, our temple grows as a precious stone. But that word there is also linked to the Hebrew word in Ezekiel called fiery stones. This is just too good to be true, this Henry. It's as if this Bible thing is just, is it real? Oh yeah. So we are called fiery stones. We are children of God, sons and daughters of God, who are surrounded by a protective thing called fire, God's holy fire, when we pray, and God's angel armies are set into motion. I hope you're getting this. I'm only going to say this today. Let's stand, because now it's your turn again. Let's just make sure my notes are there. Oh yeah. So I'm going to play that song which we've sung, but now we're going to really mean it, and now we're going to see it. And that song is, what's it called again?
Your Angel Army.
That's the one. Halfway through, we got a breakthrough. Whatever God's going to do with you, you're going to get a breakthrough today in something. But more than that, he wants you to, much more valuable than that. Anyone want anything more valuable than that? Anyone want anything more valuable than that? He wants more valuable. Just didn't want to put his hand in. There he goes. It's that much more valuable than that. He wants you to see God and see his ways. His ways are precious, powerful, and eternal, and they will last you for eternity. So we're going to play this song, and can we just have a little bit on that? Just a little low, and then we're going to put it on full volume. And I'm going to be praying for you to realize that you are in an army. You are in God's angel army. That you are surrounded by his heavenly realm. That when you pray, you are protected by a Holy Spirit of fire. And he doesn't want that to be one-offs. He wants you to live in the knowledge of that in your heart, that a fire is in you. And that fire does those two things. It's going to burn out the garbage that's in you and purify you. The stuff that you might want to be holding on to, if he wants to burn it, you pray this. You ask for fire, he's going to do it. But you're also going to see signs and wonders and miracles and the wonders of God's love. Who shall we fear? Who can be against it if God is for us? The Holy Spirit that brought back Jesus from death to life wants to bring back you to an awareness more of the reality of God's power and love. That same Holy Spirit lives in you. Who shall we fear? He's right by our side. Ask for his fire. Don't. Lord, can I have a little bit of fire, please? You demand his fire because he wants to give it you. You shout for his fire during this song and watch the wonders of God as he unfolds and manifests himself in your life. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
He is a friend of mine. power upon us now, Lord, I pray. Holy Spirit, come in the fullness of your Holy Spirit outpouring, just as it was in Pentecost. Fire has touched each one of them. For those who are of you, for those who wanted more of you, let your Holy Spirit fire touch us all right now in the glorious name of Jesus, the name above all names, the beautiful name who gives us eternal life in you. Lord, you're our healer, you're our way maker, you're a promise keeper, you are everything, Jesus, in your name. Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you,
Jesus. Such a
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Any of your body not filled up, equipped, or topped up or overflowing? Okay. If you would like just a little bit more, or if there's anybody here who feels that they just need prayer to just set them off a little bit more, to give their lives, wherever stage you may be at, we have a prayer team who will be just thrilled to pray with you today. There's nothing wrong in having more. I think, you know, God's got a little bit more room for you to want more. He will love that. Love that. I hope you've enjoyed today. It has been a great day. Amen?
Amen.
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 Amen. We have been filled, Lord. I thank you, Lord, that, oh my word. Did you come? Yes, you come. Because you love to be with us, Lord. And we love to be with you. Praise your name, Lord. I pray that we have touched your heart today, Lord. Father, you have touched mine. And many here, I am sure. Father, send us out. Send us out, Lord. With you, speaking of you, continuing, Lord. This is not it. We don't just stop here. We continue to go on with you, Lord. Thank you that together, we have gathered together today to be encouraged, to be equipped, to be filled, to make that step, to take another level, that we will see, Father, your ways at work. And why? Because we believe, Lord. We believe, Lord, that you are at work. We just have to wait and see of the miracles of you. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.